see Chuck Berry down the street at the Duck Room. It's like going to church. Every time you saw him, it was great. And that's where I met Charles Berry and Ingrid, and it was amazing. His star is there on the St. Louis Walk of Fame, right in front of Blueberry Hill. And then he opened up the pageant. He was the first show at the pageant. Did you know that? Chuck Berry. And he loves St. Louis, and that's for sure. And we all love him, and that's why you're here tonight. That's why this band is here, and so many great guitarists. And we're glad that you're here. So, you're awful damn quiet. I don't know why.
They are quiet.
Come on. It's Chuck Berry music, damn it. Alright, so I've known this guy for 22 years. First time I saw him play was at Boomer's on the Landing. And if somebody would have told me 22 years later you'd be here at this venue and you'd be doing this for tonight, I would have told you. You're fucking crazy. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Zito and friends. Hey, how you doing out here, St. Louis? This night is about one thing, and it's about Chuck Berry, the king of rock and roll. We'll be right back.
you to please put your hands together one more time for Dr. Slappenstein out here tonight. Yeah, it's a good day to be here. This time me at the wheel. I stole a kiss at the turn of a mile. I curiosity running wild. Cruising and playing the radio. No particular place to go. Riding along an automobile. I zinced to tell her the way I feel. So I told her softly and sincere. She leaned and whispered in my ear. We're kind of low and driving slow, with no particular place to go. Come on, Lewis. For coming out here tonight. Thank you. Put your hands together for St. Louis right here. This is a dream come true, let me tell you. It is a dream come true. I thought about getting to do this for a long time, and here we are. It's pretty unbelievable, and you're here. In November, we released an album called Rock and Roll. It's Mike Zito and friends, a tribute to Chuck Berry. We recorded 20 Chuck Berry songs with 21 guest guitar players. And it was, let me tell you, quite a feat. But we pulled it off. Right now, I want to bring this young man to come out here and join us on the, this is the first track that we recorded. Mr. Charlie Berry, ladies and gentlemen. You saw him at Dr. Slavenstein. He's gonna come out here and play music with me all night long. You know, I gotta tell you, the hardest thing about doing this is trying to do the best we can with these lyrics and the words. This man was one of the best songwriters ever in America. And if you don't know that, you need to know that. I mean, pure poetry. And so many words, just beautiful. This particular song here really always caught me because, one, because I'm born and raised in South St. Louis. We're from St. Louis. So, maybe you like it. There, Mr. Charlie Berry, everybody.
Like, how did he talk you into this kind of thing?
well,
I guess when a St. Louis, a fellow St. Louis, which I still consider my, comes, asks me to do something, you know.
Right, right.
Like, how are you going to say no? Especially when you got people like...
Chuck Berry's a big influence and stuff like that?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. From St. Louis.
Yeah.
Are you still a St. Louis?
I'm still a St. Louis, yeah. I live here. I got two places here.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. That's good. Fact, I'm just selling my apartment in New York now. That's how full-time I am here.
Really? You don't mind the cold?
What's that?
You don't mind the cold?
No.
Well, this is what we're doing. This is the best music in rock and roll right here. We're going to bring out a guest for you right now that is, look, he was famous in St. Louis when I was still in high school, and he gave me my first guitar lesson. Put your hands together for Mr. Richard Fortus right here. Sure, you know him from a band called Guns N' Roses, but I know him from a band called The Odds. So there you go. Thank you. guitarist and foremost. I appreciate you, brother. Finally get to play a little guitar with you. We're going to take you just a little bit south, Lee.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is St. Louis's own right there. That's a guitar hero all over the world. Came here tonight to play for you. To celebrate Chuck Berry in St. Louis right here. Mr. Richard Fortus, everybody. All right, we're going to have fun, ain't we? Please feel free to sing along if you know the words. This is a party. All right, I'm not in concert. We're here to be having a good time together. So yell the words out. Get crazy. Have fun with this, St. Louis. Arrested on charges of unemployment. He was sitting in the witness stand. Georgia, wild card of the district attorney said, you can pay that brown eyed man. You want your job, you better pay that brown eyed man.
Come on.
ladies and gentlemen. Trumpet, ladies and gentlemen, right there from Houston, Texas. Put your hands on Mr. Fernando Castillo, everyone. Back here on the drums from Houston, Texas. Put your hands together for him. Mr. Matthew Johnson, all night long. I want you to know who the band is. And last but not least, from St. Louis, Missouri, on the bass guitar. We go all the way back 22 years playing at Boomers in the back room in the 1990s. Mr. Douglas Burkett right here, everybody. Oh, Lord. You having fun? You like it? Enjoying yourself? Good. Thank you. The next guest artist that we're going to bring out here for you right now is one of my favorite guitar players in the whole world. I've been trying to learn everything he does, and there's too much. I can't do it. You're going to love it. This is one of the greatest guitar players alive today, Mr. Robin Ford, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for him.
We did a gig. I don't even think I can count the number of adjustments. You know, it was like get up in the morning after 2 hours sleep, drive 2.5 hours, get on a ferry.
Yeah.
For 2.5 hours, get in a car, drive across the island, get in a ferry, 2.5 hours, drive to the gig, play the gig finally after hours and hours. Ona Filter, it was an Ona Filter.
Oh, yeah, so that was TV, man. So you had to Neil Young, the TV.
we all got dressed up. We had to be there for hours.
Yeah,
It's TV.
Michael Al.
Yeah, Michael Al.
Yeah.
And then got in the van, drove 2.5 hours to a hotel, slept for 1.5 hours, got in the van, drove to the ferry, took the ferry, crossed the island, took the ferry, and went to another gig.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. That's the most awesome trip I think I ever took.
Yeah.
And leave it all around.
I told you, the one and only Robin Ford. Thank you so much for being here, Robin. It means the world to me. And Fernando sounds pretty good back there on the trumpet, I assume. Take Fernando home with you tonight. Y'all want to dance a little? There's some people dancing this song. I've seen it before. ladies and gentlemen, Robin Ford. The one and only. You see these beautiful pictures we got back here? I turn around and see that. It almost made me choke up for a minute. Let's bring Mr. Charlie Berry back out here right now. We're going to let him sing this next cut for you and lead the band. Oh, and how about this band? The band's doing an awesome job, aren't they? This band right here played on that record. You take that record home with you and let this band in the privacy of your own house, including Mr. Charlie Berry.
How we doing, everybody? You know, it looks like I got a chance to sing one. So we got rock and roll music. Here we go.
said, you're going to do the splits with me? And I thought, I'm not getting up. I'm not going to be able to get up. It'll end here. I'll fall over on my ass in front of everybody. Ooh, Lord. So we got people here from all over around St. Louis, don't we, Ryan? Is there anybody here from South St. Louis? That's my people. Anybody here from the north side? That's like the other side of the world to me. Anybody here from Cape Girardeau, Missouri? And the Rude Dog Pub? Where did you say you're from, man? From Wisconsin. Of course you are. How are you, brother? It's so good to see you, man. I'm so glad you're here. What a beautiful night it is. Thank you all so much for being here. Oh my gosh. You ready for some more? All right. About 20 years ago, we did a thing. First of all, I want to thank KC95 for just making life livable in St. Louis, Missouri, all through the 70s and 80s and 90s. Just taping all the shit they played on the radio in the early 80s so I could listen to it over and over. Thank you, KC. Thank you, my good friend, Guy Favaz, the mighty Favaz. Just all the support and all the rock and roll. This city, that is, it's so awesome. They ain't got a radio station like that everywhere, y'all.
How about if I go this way?
There you go.
Yeah, this
way. That was thick?
Yeah, and we're over
that's
here.
My hair looks good.
Your hair's good?
There's one.
Man. Right on.
Yeah, you all.
Shit.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Ain't getting better.
So you may remember about 20 years ago, we did a thing at the pageant called the Jimmy Jam. Anybody? You know, we only got to do it one time, but it was hellacious. And this man coming up right now was the headliner then. I remember thinking, I've never seen anybody play guitar like that before. And I still ain't never seen nobody play guitar like that before. It's one of the most exciting and greatest guitar players on the planet right now. You put your hands together for the one and only Mr. Eric Gales, everybody.
St. Louis, how y'all doing out there? Y'all all right? Real briefly, I don't know if everybody knows me and Mike's backstory, but we kind of rode them hard and put them up wet for quite a few years. And he had to help remind me of that particular gig that we met at almost 20 years ago, next door. And I only remembered by looking at the back of the place. Because ironically, that's unfortunately where I spent most of my time doing damage to myself. But here we are, 20-something years later. Life couldn't be more better than what it is for me. I said life couldn't be more better than what it is for me. And I just wanted to make it known in his hometown that Mike Zito, I am very honored to be here amongst all of these badass musicians. So, brother, nobody told you. I'm here to tell you I am damn proud of you. Y'all give it up for Mike Zito!
Well, good night, everybody. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed yourself. Let's end on a high note right now. Pull a Costanza. That's right. You know, all of our guests here tonight have all performed on the Chuck Berry record that we did. You know, there's so many things to celebrate about Chuck Berry. And I'm going to tell you again, the true king of rock and roll. Okay, that's it. Period. singer, songwriter, troubadour, guitar hero, everything, you know? So we tried to celebrate this record every which way we can, and part of it was just, look at all these great guitar players we have, and would we even be playing guitar like this if there was no Chuck Berry? And the answer is no.
Home. Thank you.
blessing ever from the church. Without you, man. I promise, we put our heart into this. We started working on this show last summer, trying to get people together and trying to bring a great show for you to try to celebrate this record and this music. And I cannot thank you enough for being here tonight and for filling the room for us. I hope we can do it again and again, like next year. And I want to especially thank the Berry family. From what I understand, there are quite a few members of the Berry family here tonight. And thank you so much for sharing this music and letting us play this music. It's an honor to play this music. There is nobody up here. We cannot play it like Chuck Berry. We cannot sing it like Chuck Berry. Okay, but we can enjoy it and love it and do what we do, and we're so thankful. I had the honor of getting to meet Mr. Berry several times. His son brought him. I used to work at a music store called Tower Grove Music. It was on Gravois. Down from Grand and Gravois there, and they still had the Azair Plaza. Act like I'm not from St. Louis. Tell me. I lived on 3949 Fairview between Gustine and Roger. 314-865-3832. Don't call it. I don't know who's living it now. By the way, I lived in a four-family flat for 14 years in the upper left apartment. And I think about 5 years ago, somebody got killed up there. So, good times. I love it. I love St. Louis. I love it. So I worked at that music store. It was just blocks away from me. I worked there for a decade. It's now called Eddie's Guitars, and it's not far from here. It's one of the world-class guitar shops. So Chuck Berry came in the store a couple of times. I got to meet him. I got to shake his hand. Some of the musicians that played with him came in the store. I was very young, but I appreciated it. And eventually, I did get the chance to open up for him right up the street here at the Duck Room at Blueberry Hill. It was a huge honor, huge honor. So I'll tell you this story just because I think it's funny. So I got to open up for Chuck Berry one time. It's a big deal. I was living in Cape Girardeau working at Horizon Guitar Cables, Dave Boyer, wherever you at. And I said, man, I need to bring a gift. And what do you give Chuck Berry as a gift, ladies and gentlemen? Man had earned the world and deserved it. So I had a guitar cable made for him. And on the shrink wrap, I had it engraved. It said, "My Ding-a-Ling." I'm not lying. And he liked it. I want you to sing along. Come on now, we're gonna have a party. This is rock and roll. Come on. politically incorrect rock and roll. The real shit right here. That's what the whole thing's made of. For you. I saved a good one for last, y'all. I got a good one for you now. I need to catch my breath. Let me just tell you. In 1998, myself and Doug Burkett and Brian Zeely, who's here somewhere, we made a record called Blue Room. We recorded it out in South County, and I gave it to my friend Favaz at KC, and he liked it. And he told me that there was a man by the name of Walter Trout coming to play at Mississippi Nights. I was a huge Walter Trout fan. And he had a big hit on the radio at the time here. He was coming to play Mississippi Nights, and they sent him my CD to see if he would let us open up for him And believe it or not, he said we could. So 22 years ago, we opened up for Walter Trout at Mississippi Nights. And I still remember, it just changed my life. This man right here, this is my hero. All right? He helped me get clean and sober when I was down and out. He's there for me when I call him on the phone. He was trying to get me a record deal 20 years ago. I don't even know why he's not tired of me. I've been bugging the shit out of him forever. And he is one of the best blues, rock, period, whatever you want to call them, kind of guitar players to ever live. Pure heart and soul. Please put your hands together for the one and the only, Mr. Walter Trout, ladies and gentlemen. Awesome, huh?
Yeah! Woo! I might even, you know, change my clothes and brush my teeth. You know what I mean? Hey, going all the way for this gig.
So,
I'm
not gonna Neil Young this one.
I ain't Neil Young in it, man. You don't change your clothes, you don't comb your hair, you don't brush your teeth. Okay. You know, you just
That's why he looks like
Neil Young gig.
Yeah.
I always wondered if it was intentional.
Yeah.
But actually it's just who he is.
We saved some blues for you now. I hear it off in the distance. It's getting louder. It's piercing my soul. That's it. Thinking about you. Walter Trout, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only. We're going to ask Mr. Charlie Berry to come out and join me and Walter on this next song. Charlie, come on out here, please. Put your hands together for this young man again. You hanging in there with me? You good? You ain't getting tired, are you? I was bragging on your ass all week. We were in Columbia last night, Kansas City the night before. They don't know how to win World Series over there, man. They don't know how to win those things. It's like new. They're like new kids over there. I want you to sing. You ready? Just let me hear some other rock and roll. It's got a back, baby, you can't lose. Yeah, no time to use it. Gotta be a rock and roll music. If you wanna dance with me, if you wanna dance with me. I got no kick against my budget, unless they try to play it too darn fast. And there's the beauty of a melody. It's all sounding like a symphony. That's why I go for that rock and roll. Baby over across the tracks. Hear my man and he goes wailing sax. I must admit they had a rocking band. Woo! He was falling for a whole band. And they were playing that rock and roll. They were going to lose. Got a baby you can't lose. They were going to time to use it. Gotta be rock and roll music. If you want to dance to me. Yeah. nice rock right there. I want you to give him a rousing round of applause. To Charlie Berry over here to the left, ladies and gentlemen, make a lot of noise for him. I should say Charlie Berry the third, ladies and gentlemen. So, I got an idea, and tell me if you want to, if you like it.
Oh my God.
How about we ask Rich Fortas and Eric Gales and Robin Ford to all come out here? And just, let's do it. Would you like to see that, St. Louis? You want to see it happen? It's going to happen right here. I don't know if it ever happened again. Put your hands together for these fine gentlemen. And good-looking fellas, too. Not just talented, good-looking fellas. Put your hands together for them. It's about to get real. Please also thank you to everybody here at Del Mar Hall. They've just been fantastic. The management, the club, Pat Hagen, the sound, my good friend Bob Horner back there at the board. Everybody's been wonderful. It's been a beautiful night for me and for the band, and you made it happen right here. Because if y'all didn't show up, we're just playing with ourselves. We'll be right back. 2021, right?
Thank you.
so much, St. Louis. We did it! We did it! Thank you to the Big Blues Band. Y'all getting free coffee in the morning. Thank you, gentlemen. Let's all sing it together. You ready? Stay right there. Well, his mother told him someday you will be a man, and you will be the leader of a big old band. Many people coming from miles around. Yeah, you play the guitar till the sun goes down. Never saw nothing make a million lights. Everything good to night. I said, go, go, Johnny, go, go. Get everybody out here. We're going to take a nice big bow so you can get a picture, all right? One more time, give it up for these fine musicians right here.
We did one thing once that I'll never do again. We played Thursday night in Switzerland. We played Friday night in England. We played Saturday afternoon in New York and Sunday night in Amsterdam.
Damn!
Nah, that beats it.
And we're on stage at the Paradiso right after all of that. And I'm up there playing and my drummer, he's back there going, "You motherfucker! The fuck? Fuck you, mother!" I turn around after I said, "What the hell's? What's your problem?" And he goes, "We've been up here 3.5 hours."
Are you kidding
me? I was just so.
You just forgot.
I forgot.
Yeah.
And he's back there just going, "Well, man," you know.
And what did you do?
I said, "Good night, everybody."
Okay.
We played the last song.
Right.
I didn't realize but that was literally. We had this chance to open a big amphitheater in New York, open for Sammy Hagar, and our label was like, "Oh, you got to do this gig."
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as we finished the gig in England Friday night, they put us on a plane. We flew to New York, and it was in the afternoon. The label, it was Ira Leslie. Were you on Roof at all, ever? Okay, it was Ira Leslie from Roof. He picks us up in a van. We drive to the Jones Beach Amphitheater or whatever the fuck and play for Sammy Hagar, they put us right back in the van and fly us to the Paradiso. And,
wow.
You know.
So needless to say, all them gigs you just named, y'all Neil Young did.
We Neil Young. That was a four-night Neil Young extravaganza, man.